What's up, internet? I'm Manish from RebellionRider.com and I'm back once again with another SQL tutorial for you all. This is the third tutorial in Null Function series, and here we will discuss yet another SQL function, which is Coalesce. Is it the correct pronunciation? Coalesce? I really don't know. Anyways, so without further delay, let's get started. Coalesce is another function which can help you in dealing with null values in Oracle database. Here is the syntax of the same. As you can see here, unlike NVL and NVL2 functions which we have discussed previously, Coalesce function can take n number of arguments, and as a result it returns the first parameter from the argument list which is not null. If in case all the arguments are evaluated as null, then this function returns null as a result. Okay, now let's come to SQL developer and do some practical queries that will help you in understanding this concept more clearly. If it does so, then please give this video a thumbs up. You can also comment or tweet and tell me how you like this video. Believe me, positive comments always make my day and bring a big smile on my face. So be shameless and write down what you feel. Okay, enough talking, let's get back to business. I will start with a very lightweight simple query. See, I told you a simple query. As we know, Coalesce returns first not null argument from the parameter list. So on execution, our result should be 1, as 1 is the first non-null value in the parameter list. So let's execute. And as predicted, the result is 1. That's another version of Coalesce function. Here I'm using string as a parameter. Unlike previous query where first parameter was null, here third parameter is null. On executing this query, Coalesce function will return the first not null values from the parameter list, which is the string rebellion. So let's execute. And here we are. These two examples are just to make you understand the working of this particular function Coalesce clearly. Now you must be wondering, what is the use of this function in real life application? So to answer this question, let's do another example. This time for the demonstration, I have created a table and the name of this table is Avengers. Yes, you heard it right guys, it's Avenger and we are back again. Okay, fine, I'm good now. So let me show you the structure of this table first. And here is the structure of this table. As you can see, this table has 4 columns: first name, last name, mobile number and landline number. I also have some data in this table. Let me show you that also. And here, as you can see, some Avengers have both mobile and landline numbers, while some either have a mobile number or a landline number. Now, suppose you have to write a query or say make a report to list the name of all the Avengers along with their contact number. Let's write our first query. Okay. This is a correct query, but the only problem with it is that you will not be able to get contact of all the Avengers who doesn't have mobile numbers, as you can see here in the result. Let me close this query result. Now let's execute this one. As you can see, similar result will be returned when you retrieve data from column landline. There are two solutions of this problem. First is to write a query which will return the data from both landline and mobile column. Let me show you how. This makes your report look crappy, don't you think so? The second and a neat solution of this problem is that you can use Coalesce function on column landline and mobile. That will make your report clearer. Let me show you how you can use Coalesce function with both the column landline and mobile. But before that, let me close this query result. Okay, now let's write the query. Now let's execute this query. Don't you think that this result looks better than the previous one? Like this, you can use this function on employees table or student tables while making reports. You know what? You can help me learning more about this function. For that, you just have to comment and tell me what are the other uses of this function. How and where can we use it? Also, if you have any crazy query, then feel free to write that in comment box, or you can tweet me also at RebellionRider. That's it for today's guys. With this, I will take your leave. We'll be back soon with some more tutorials. This is your friend Manish from Rebellion Rider.